Hello everyone and welcome back to Dark Souls 2, The Helpful Summon. My name is Acting Rogue, and since we have completed the main game, let's attempt to see if we can get any summons in the DLC. So, we are going to go to Sanctum Interior, and I'm going to drop down to where Nadia is and see if I can place my summon sign down and get some summons. I'm recording at a different time of the day, so hopefully I will get a few more than not at all. And hopefully the Drake Knights don't come and kill me. That'd be very helpful. Oh, okay. Apparently they can see you all the way from here. That's interesting. Oh, hi guys. How are you? I'd rather not fight both of you. Get off my plane! Ah, shit. Gotcha. Not that bad. Okay, this way. Roll! Bup. 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 Okay. Summon sign. Down. Alright, since this may take a bit, I'll go over a few things. So, in the break from last time, I managed to go kill Vendrick. Okay, I think I should be okay. I managed to kill Vendrick with my, I think it was the +4 Manslayer. Hang on one sec here. Sorry about that technical glitch there. Just fixing that up. Anyways, come on, give me some summons. I'd really like to fight this boss. Yes, excellent. Come on! For fuck's sakes. Try it again. Try it again here. I beat... Vendrick isn't that bad. I managed to beat him with... the Manslayer, just by all you have to really do is stay to his left foot and just continue his slash at him and just recorrect when he does his backdash into like a wall or something. Oh, nice. We're going with someone who's the Fume Greatsword. All right, let's do this. Get her! Holy shit, she nearly killed me. That's the pulse, yep. So I like her more than Nashandra because she has actually more to her, because she has, like, she has the dark power, she has all the, like, summon stuff. Though summoning Vel'Stad is a little cheap, I'll say, but Like, beyond that, she's actually a decent boss because she's just the final boss, but a little more, like, a little more to her and a little more difficult. Ah, that's the pulse. Yep. Back off. Yeah. She's best fought with two, I'd say, instead of three. Like, even though Steelheart Ellie is a decent summon, that's Velstad. Yeah, that's Velstad. Now, this is where the fight gets a little cheap, because Velstad is still at... I think he's only diminished slightly in his normal strength. I'll give her a hand here. Oi! Tank man. Shit! This is actually a pretty hard fight. That's the overhead. Now the one problem is if you focus on Velstad too much, then you won't be able to see if Nidalia throws out like one of her fire projectiles like that. And there's the pursuer ones, which is going to be pretty bad, which we'll see if she launches or not. There's one, two, three, she caught me with one of them. And there's Velstad again, oh Jesus. I'll go in and wail on her. God, that axe is powerful. Like, I don't think even the Nashandra's scythe is that heavy of stamina damage for blocking it. That's the fire. I really should have buffed my weapon. Come on, do some shit, lady. Oh, come on. Leave the host alone. Damn it. This is why you don't bring in both the AI summon and a human summon, because two human summon, like, the host and yourself, as long as you're powerful enough. Ah, shit, I'm not enough. Hang on. I'm gonna port back to bonfire. Get my thing back up to full. Because she's not too bad, but she can get overpowered really quickly. Especially if Well, with that, we kind of forced her to be more powerful. Because we had both the AI and the and myself in, so it makes her way more powerful than she should be. Okay. So let's reconstruct here for a sec. Equipment. Take that thing off and give me... Do I want this or this? I might want the third dragon ring. Yeah, I guess that helps me out a little bit. Give me some boost. Alright, equipment. Now I want on this taskbar. I want the lightning and a grab. Strength. Carve in like that. Now I can do old growth. Now I can get know what I should do is set that up to old growth. Damn it! Wasn't quick enough. But hopeful. Same person or different person? Let's find out. Hey, it's the same person. Awesome. Let's get that boss. Oh, or is she grabbing another human summon? These two humans wouldn't be too bad. I've seen it done with three. And I really should. Well, since I have this time, I will now put lightning on my tab bar here. Sick. We've got two. Okay, katana and magic user. Doing dark? Okay, cool. Let's rock. Get her! Oh, he's using the Chaos Blade. Okay, that's a much better start. Yeah, like, her teleports actually make her a little more interesting. That's Velstad. Get away! That fire is really powerful. That fire nearly killed me. Because it does a lot. That's the burst, or is that, no, that's the fire. She can do double fire, I forgot. That's the fire. Alright, that's one of us. I didn't really need to heal. Nice. That Fume Knight sword is awesome. That's the pursuers. I will use to charge up my weapon again. Ah, shit. Here comes Velstad again. Shield! No! Oh. That was a good set. That's the burst. You just keep fighting the Velstad. I'll tank the boss. Oh shit! Those cheeky teleports. Plus, he's also poison Velstad. He's not normal Velstad. Like, he's poison and dark. Oi, over here. Shit! God damn it, that's me. Fuck! This is why I say we go in with two. Because with two, you can do a way easier job of her. She isn't as bad if you just have two people. Because if you have three, her health is way higher up. Where am I at? I'm at nine. I can lay my thing down again. Okay, is there anything else I can add to this that makes this a little better? That's fire defense. That's not really going to do a whole lot. Probably switch up my equipment a little bit more. wait around here for a bit. As you may have also seen, I now have all of Vendrick's stuff, so I now have... I now have the King's Crown. I sadly will not, of course, be able to fight Aldi, at least on this run. I may have to... I will probably either do that another run or come in and summon for him. Because I don't know what you get as a reward if you do beat him. Because I didn't see anything in the way of, like, cool weaponry or something. Most of the other cool weaponry that I don't have yet is from the DLCs. Like, the only real... weapon that I really want is the Fume Greatsword, just because it is now the best greatsword in the game. It's way more powerful than this greatsword, and it has S scaling similar, but I think its scaling might be slightly better. I'm just tempted to see if I can run it myself. Just on my own. Will you get out of the corner, woman? Come on, then. Throw your pursuers at me. That's Velstad. Fuck. Hello, Royal Aegis. How are you? Shit. Oh, God. She's not that hard. Like, the only thing that really makes her cheap is the ability to summon in Velstar. Because beyond that, she's not that bad. As bosses go. Especially for this, well, she's the second worst. Like, most unfair boss. The most unfair still goes to the gang squad, which I will see if people want help with, because that is one where having a summon would actually be kind of helpful. So I didn't even get to test if that was effective. I'm going to switch to fire and see if that works any better. Fuck it. You know what? I want to fight her again. I want another round. Because I think I can do her on my own. Oh yeah. Like that opening combo? That did a chunk for health alone. And that's Velstad. Fine, bitch. If you're gonna play by those rules, let's go. Come here, Velstad. That's the fire. That somehow did not kill me. This might. Yep! Fuck! Roll! You gonna top with this cheap bullshit? Or what? Come on, bitch. Fight me for real here. It really is just Velstad. If it wasn't for Velstad, this would be one of the easiest bosses in the entire game. Like, she would be actually just a better Nashandra. Can they hit through their each other's hitboxes? I can't remember. Fuck you, bitch! I'm gonna try bringing in. I'll try getting summoned again, and then I'll try bringing in Steelheart Ellie, because really, summons in this game are built, especially these ones are built just for, just to be distractions, and that's what I need right now. You. You're coming with me. Let's do this. Burst. She doesn't do a lot, but I don't need her to do a lot because I can do that. Oh, this is going to be a lot easier. If you would kindly leave the skeletons alone, please. Oh yeah. Like, literally just having a distraction is the best thing for this fight. Because it's just one person. To be able to do, like, damage doesn't matter. I can do the damage. Shield. It's just as long as we have... Okay, let's just wail on her. Come on, one more sit. Yeah. And with that, I say adieu, madam. Woo! We win! And now this sick, awesome sequence. Where the doors of fate have opened. Alright. Sign down. Oh wait, what I should do first is actually just rest. There we go. Very nice. Therefore, try attacking. In short, don't give up. What happened to this guy? Hey, look! It's our friend. Pick my sign! Pick my sign! Oh. Because the next part is actually one of my favorite parts of this DLC of all. Just because of... Yeah, fuck it, I'm gonna do it. Which one is which? That is the mage, that does not matter. This is the one. Transient Eddie is the one summon I will bring into this fight. Just because he is useful for a slight amount of distraction and I will tank... the additional health that comes with it. Come on, Transient Eddie. And it's cool, he has the AI to be able to bow to the person who summons him. Alright, let's do this. So it looks all normal. Looks fine. Until you realize that's not just some darkness. That's a fucking dragon. With a giant lance shoved through it. And he hits like a fucking truck, but he's so goddamn cool, I don't even care. Plus, he doesn't just do fire damage. He does poison fire. And he's the reason, essentially, this DLC exists, because... And it's not just poison, it's toxic. It's the higher grade poison. Come on, do some swings here, buddy. I need to fight you. Roll. Roll. Swing. Okay, yeah. This is definitely manageable. You can kind of get lost in him because he is a big dragon. I'll be taking Yorg's ring. It's a decent ring, as I remember. That's the swipe, and that's a kill. So Sin's rad as fuck, so I can't even be mad if he kills me. Like, he is one of my favorite bosses of this game. Because he is sort of a reference back to Dark Souls 1 of the giant black dragon of called Calamede. In the way he fights and stuff like that. And especially the way he fights. Hang on a sec here. Okay. And the way he fights in and around his arena. I'm gonna see if I can solo him. I only have a couple growth bombs left, but that's okay. I'm gonna see if I can just take this on solo. Because he's not too bad. Because once, all you have to do is memorize when to roll and stuff like that. Come here, Sin. That's the charge. Now, the one disappointing thing is, once again, since this is Dark Souls 2, even if you lop off his tail, you won't get anything for it. Whereas, I feel like you should. Yeah, that's near double damage. Ow. That's breathe fire. Oh, Jesus. I have a literal pixel of health. And he can do that backdash that can kill you. God damn it, Sin, you're so cool. And there goes 54k souls, which is kind of annoying. But it's okay, because I think he drops 80k, and at this point, I don't want to level up too much more. And I can also just go grind shit like Giant Lord and stuff like that. I'm gonna do him without doing the specs up. And see if I... Gone then. God damn it, Sin. I think some of his stuff is in fact unblockable. But, like, he can destroy all the columns and shit in this arena. It's not too bad a damage reduction. Do your fire breathe move. I rolled too early. So. God. He's tough, but he's so... It's so fair in how he's designed. Try this again. Because I think I can do it without the buffs. You just run towards him as he does the fire stuff. Of course, keeping an eye on where he actually lands is a good idea. And he can also spend a good portion of the boss fight just in the air. And he can also land on you. Sin, you're so fucking cool. Can't even... Fuck! Ah! And there's the strike down, which ticked me. God damn it. Do your fire breath move, damn you. Not that one, the other one. The one where you're on the ground and you do it. And not the flyby. The flyby is cheap as shit. Like, as you can see, he's not bad. Like, the flying thing is kind of annoying, but he is a dragon, so I would expect nothing less. Fuck. That caught me. That's the fire. But even that you can roll out of the way of. Fucking God damn it. As long as you stay towards his hindquarters and he doesn't do that, you're pretty good. Though he can stomp on you like that. God damn it, Sim. You're causing me to screw up. Because you are really big. You're not the biggest one, because that goes to the ancient dragon, which I will probably never fight. Because there's no real point. Because you don't get an achievement for it. You don't earn anything from him but a giant soul, and the only reason you want a giant soul is to go fight Vendrick. Like, the way to get the ancient dragon soul is to go into the dragon memory after you get the Ashen Heart and miss. So there's no reason to go fight him. Plus, he's still one of the most broken bosses in the game just by the moves he can do. Fuck. God damn it, Sin. You're so powerful, but you're so cool. Plus, you helped me out before in this level because you breathed fire on a couple dudes. Alright. I'm gonna pop a humanity in. Bring in Eddie again. See if we can get a better. Get our match this time. I think I'll go in with fire. Just fire. Come on, Eddie. Let's go. God damn it, Sin. You get him, Eddie. Will you please come down? Thank you. And there he goes, back up again. Land, damn you. So it can get a little annoying. I will say that. Because for some reason, Sin's AI pathing just... I get it, he's a dragon, so he has to fly around, but for fighting purposes, it's just a little annoying, is all. Plus, blocking his moves is not a good idea. You get him, Eddie. That was bad. You got him, Eddie. See, like, you can break off his tail, but you don't get anything for it. Like, Dark Souls 1, you would get a cool sword. In fact, that's how you get one of the coolest swords in the game. A sword I have never gotten because Seath is fucking bullshit. And I'd rather just kill him than try and fight his stupid gimmick of being able to cut off his tail. Gaping dragon? Easy. Calamite, probably harder, but still possibly better than Seath. Come on, Sin. Do one of your crazy fire moves. Not that one. The one where you're on the ground. That was a bad idea. But that will get me this. But it won't, because he's in the corner. God damn it, Sin. I'll take this time to heal. Run forwards. Shield up. One or two more swings here. And don't you do some bullshit that will kill me. There. Ta-da! Thank you, Transient Eddie. You have been helpful. 72k. That's pretty good. And of course, we now claim the crown of the Sunken King. Faint heat lingers in the crown. Let's take a look at this thing. It's not bad. Of course, the main king's crown has better stats. Anyways. Well, sadly, once again, not too many summons. The next thing I will be doing is trying to get a couple summons in the at the Gank Squad arena, and if not, yeah, I think we're coming to the end. Unless I decide to get the DLCs, which is a possibility. But my main intention with this was to just go through the main game. So, yep. Go with that. I guess I'll see you guys later.